Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. JPA and Hibernate provide two standard options to map an enum to a database column. You can either use its string representation or its ordinal value. But what do you do if you need to map values from a legacy database that don't match these standard mappings? Or if you don't want to accept the drawbacks of the standard mapping? The string representation is verbose, and renaming an enum value requires you also to update your database. The ordinal of an enum value is its position in the enum declaration. This value changes and requires you to update your database when you remove an existing value or don't add new values to the end of the enum declaration. In all these situations, you need to define a custom mapping. But no worries. That's pretty easy since JPA 2.1 introduced AttributeConverter. Let's talk about AttributeConverter in general before we dive into the details of the custom enum mapping. AttributeConverter were introduced in JPA 2.1. They allow you to implement methods to convert between the database and the Java representation of an attribute type. You can use it to convert all basic attributes defined by an entity class, a mapped superclass, or an embeddable class. The only exceptions are ID attributes, version attributes, relationship attributes, and attributes annotated with temporal or enumerated. The implementation of an attribute converter is pretty simple. You just need to annotate the class with converter and implement the attribute converter interface with its two methods, convert to database column and convert to entity attribute. You can see that here on the slide. X is the entity attribute type you want to persist and Y the type you want to store in the database. Enough theory. Let's jump into the IDE and implement such an attribute converter. Here you can see the author status enum which I want to persist in the database. I use it in the author entity to indicate if an author published a book with a publishing house, or as a self-published book, or if she is still writing the book and hasn't published it yet. You can see here that I don't annotate it with the enumerated annotation as you would normally do. As I said earlier, you can't use attribute converter with attributes that are annotated with enumerated. And you don't need that annotation because you provide your own mapping of the enum values. I implement that mapping with this attribute converter. It implements the attribute converter interface and converts author status enums to strings. I also annotated it with converted and set the auto-apply attribute to true. That tells Hibernate to apply this converter to all entity attributes of type author status. Hibernate calls the convert to database column method to map an author status enum value to its string representation. The implementation of this method is simple. I use a switch statement to define the mapping of each enum value to a string representation and throw an illegal argument exception if there's no specific mapping for an enum value. You could also store the string representation as an enum attribute, but I decided against it because I just need it for the database mapping and don't want to pollute the domain model with it. And this method writes a short log message for each mapping. You obviously don't need that in your application, but it allows me to show the mapping in the log file. The convert to entity attribute method provides the inverse mapping and Hibernate calls it when it retrieved a value from the database. This time I use a switch statement to map each string to its enum value. Okay, that's all you need to do to implement a custom enum mapping. As I said earlier, Hibernate applies the attribute converter automatically because I set the autoapply attribute of the converter annotation to true. So let's persist and read an author entity and see what happens. I do that in this test case. I first create a new author entity, set its attributes, and persist it in the database. Then I get a new entity manager, start the transaction, and call the entity manager find method to read the author entity from the database. You can see the SQL insert statement here, and the log message written by the attribute converter in the following line. It converted the author status enum published to its database representation P. And then I read the same entity from the database with this SQL select statement. You can see the log message of the attribute converter in the following line. It mapped the string P to the author status enum published. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below.